Welcome and welcome back, everyone. Today we're going to take a deep dive into this reading and uncover what the universe wants you to know. These messages are timeless, so no matter when you stumble upon them, they carry a powerful message. Allow it to resonate as it's meant to. All right, let's dive into this reading. Whoa. So we have Strength and Two of Cups reversed. Whoa, they're popping out today. And be honest. So let's look at them up close. Strength, Two of Cups in reverse. And be honest. Interesting. So the message that I'm getting today is that you need to find the strength and be honest with yourself about some sort of troubled relationship that you're currently dealing with. So as you can see on the Be Honest card, the third eye is open. So it's saying, you know, listen to your intuitive nudges. You know, they should not be ignored. You know that whatever the situation is, this relationship, it has likely soured to the point of no return. You know, and you're probably very unhappy about this outcome. No matter what type of relationship this is, you need to be honest with yourself about the problems that you're dealing with. You know, if this is a marriage, this relationship might be on the verge of separation or divorce. You may be, or the other person may be, in denial about the depth of the problems that you're actually dealing with, you know, and the advice that's coming through is don't hold on to something that cannot be mended or fixed. And you know deep down if it can or if it cannot, because you probably have tried. This has probably been long term. This is probably not something that just came out of nowhere, but now you're facing it head on. And I keep seeing the dates of July 2nd and October 7th in my mind. And I'm also hearing the names Jonathan, Alex, and Bethany. So those main, you know, those names may resonate. I'm also feeling a very strong energy of Aquarius, Libra, and Leo. So one of these signs might be yours, it might be the other person. And I keep hearing, you need to find your inner fire and your inner strength. It's time to be bold, brave, and confident like a Leo. So you might be dimming your light. You might be suppressing who you truly are. You know, everything that you've been through, this relationship might have diminished your sunshine, you know, who you are deep within. You know, that can happen depending on the relationships that we deal with. You know, sometimes they dim our light. I'm feeling a divine masculine earth energy, which feels like Taurus. And I keep seeing three children in my mind and they're coloring with crayons. So if this has to do with a marriage or romantic partnership, there may be three children in the mix, which definitely could be one of the reasons ending this relationship is even harder. I'm also seeing a folder filled with paperwork. So this may have to do with future separation or divorce proceedings. You know, this is definitely coming to fruition. There's definitely movement going forward. And there's resistance, whether that's coming from you or the other person. And I keep seeing wine glasses and a festival. So it could be that you like to go to wine-related events, but at this festival, I'm seeing a couple and a third person. So for some of you, this might have to do with infidelity, you know, meeting someone at a festival and that person led to this, you know, decay of this relationship. However it applies to you, I'm just throwing it all out there. And I'm also seeing the number 22 in my mind. This might represent a date, It could be that you're 22 years old. It could represent 22 years of marriage before getting a divorce. But this could also have a deeper universal significance with master number 22, because master number 22 is the master builder, the architect. So this could be a reminder to you, actually coming from the universe, that is reminding you that you are the architect of your life. Even, you know, basically if something is falling apart, you have the capacity and the capability to rebuild your life on a better, and stronger foundation. Definitely let me know if any of this resonates. So looking at the cards specifically, with the Strength card opening this reading, this is definitely a reminder to you that you possess the inner strength to face any challenge, even if, you know, you're not feeling all that strong at this time, you know, based on everything that you're dealing with. The Strength card symbolizes courage, patience, and compassion. And this is reminding you that, you know, your true power comes from within. And this might actually be why it's linked to the energy of Leo, being bold, brave, and confident no matter what you're dealing with, finding your inner fire again. You know, and Strength alongside the Two of Cups reversed, this is definitely confirmation that there is some sort of imbalance or disconnect in a significant relationship in your life. This could be romantic. This could also be a friendship. This could also be family or a business partnership. Allow it to fit into your life the way that it's meant to. But the key here is to acknowledge that this imbalance exists and that you have the power to face it head on. No matter the outcome, you need to remember your strength, because there's a very good chance that you're not remembering that right now. You might be feeling very broken down, very weak. You might feel as if, you know, you have no worth because you've put all of your worth into this relationship. And so if this person is pushing you away, or rejecting you, or even if there has been some infidelity, that might be weighing heavy on your heart and your self-esteem. You might not feel very good about yourself right now, and that is what the Strength card is telling you. You have the power to rise up from this situation, become the phoenix rising from the ashes of what was, and, you know, going back to master number 22, become the architect of your life. Do not, you know, remain the passenger in your life. You need to take, you know, the steps to become the driver and drive yourself in the direction you need to go. You know, and to overcome the challenges that you're facing, because, you know, it feels very heavy. You're being asked to be honest. That's what that card is urging you to confront the truth. You know, leaving things unsaid will benefit no one at this point. And I keep hearing, you have nothing to lose, so it's necessary right now to just be honest. And this honesty is with yourself and others, which will lead to clarity and resolution that you're ultimately seeking. You know, definitely take some time, reflect on your feelings, your role in this relationship, and maybe dig deeper to the root causes of these issues. You know, open and honest communication with this person involved is basically necessary to gain clear understanding of the situation in its entirety, you know, and this comes with, you know, preparation. You need to be prepared to make tough decisions and, you know, even take responsibility for your own actions in this relationship. Even if it means, you know, in the end you have to let go, at least you gave it your all and you were completely honest with how you feel. You'll have no regrets going forward, and you definitely should have no regrets about being honest, even if the other person doesn't want to hear what you have to say. Clearing everything, you know, having a clean slate is hard, but it's also necessary so that you don't have regrets or things lingering or chains of energy still trapping you, you know, to this situation, to this person, and ultimately to the past. And I keep hearing 2 months. So something is going to be resolved in 2 months. So it's when I'm doing this reading right now, it's March. So 2 months would be May. But whenever you hear this reading, it's 2 months from this date that you're hearing this reading, that something will be resolved. I can definitely feel, you know, the weight of this situation and how overwhelming all of it is. And I keep hearing, I'm not happy, but moving on is really hard. So you might be feeling that way right now because it's true. It's not easy to walk away from a situation that you've invested in. You know, ending any kind of long-term relationship, you know, is never easy, but sometimes it's the only way to heal and to flourish in the future. You know, sometimes other people are like endless storm clouds that block out the sunshine from our lives. And it isn't until we get away from those storms that we realize how bad it was. And when we get away from those storms, we can finally, you know, thrive. So yeah, it's hard. You know, let's be real. Letting go is very, very difficult. There's nothing easy about it. People will tell you, just move on. It's not that simple, especially if you're entangled and intertwined with another person for any extended period of time. Walking away is not easy. So don't be hard on yourself if you're struggling, you know, but sometimes it is necessary because holding on to something falling apart is far more detrimental to your overall well-being. So at this time, you're being asked to trust your intuition, embrace your inner strength, and face the truth of this situation head on. You know, doing so will allow you to rise above the drama, you know, the sorrow and the pain, and it's ultimately going to lead you to a healthier and more fulfilling life. So believe in yourself, trust in yourself, and do what's going to ultimately help you heal, grow, and move on. All right, so that's all I have for you for this reading. Thank you so very much for joining me. If you haven't already done so, please be sure to like and subscribe. I will be uploading new videos each week. Also, be sure to check out my social media accounts because I do post a lot of new information there as well. I am most active on Instagram. You can find that information in the description box below. I look forward to seeing you in the next reading.